Welcome. A little compression. Messing around with some things, trying to get some audio corrected. Anyway, let's do a real quick sound check here. Hey. Cool. All right. Looks like things are working. Sorry about the continued cough. Still getting over the after effects of COVID. So tonight, as the description says, we're going to play with some new plugins. Bear Track Recording, Jeremiah, I'm glad you're here because this is your fault that I went ahead and picked up the Waves audio stuff that you recommended the other day on your stream. That I got to hear you play around with, so I'm gonna mess with it tonight just for fun on a few different projects. Noticing that my image is very, very orange on the camera. So hold on, might as well just take care of that real quick. A bit brighter in here than it usually is. Messing with some new lighting too that I think still needs a little bit of work. Oh, come on now. All right. Maybe we'll just hold on a second. All right. Yeah, just the mood lighting. Anyway, like I said, we're going to be playing with some new stuff here. So here's just a reference here, what it sounds like right now. Nitpicking. That's what we do. Okay, so not bad, really. Let's see. What are we using? Oh, we're using the riff intro. It's a pretty good, like filtered guitar tone as an intro there. Excuse me. And I'm thinking that might be good to keep. What I want to do is I want to mess around with the rhythm guitars and the bass in this. So these bigger sounding guitars. Start out with this guy. Yeah, so these plugins are like wonderfully inexpensive. So let's take a look. We got some. I push up. There's a little sizzle to it. Absolutely compressed to like crazy here. I want it that compressed. Reverb. There's no real point in stereo spread on this since it's hand, we're forcing it over anyway. Where'd you go over there? Still, let's take a closer listen here in context. Just playing around with it here. Oh, okay. It's adding a bit of a flangey feel to it, though. I'm gonna leave that off for now. I'm also not digging delay on this. Let's get back to. Back to kind of went too far out, I think, because it isn't. Oh, interesting. That's a bit counterintuitive. To be honest. Getting there. I thought that was just the reamp, which is, like you were saying, not great. No, I think you're right. that makes a big difference, doesn't it? Thanks for dropping in. I'll see you. There we go. Let's see how that hits. Here we go. Have more power to them. Alright, so that's cool. That's the guitar. So again, let's mess with bass for a second. Cool. This is already sounding pretty cool. Okay, hit. Yeah, I like the thin, that beginning. And I like the way it hits. Hey! What's going on, Mod Motor? Things are good. Playing with new plugins, trying some things out. Hoping that I don't screw everything up here. it's good. Got some new plugins to play with. These Chris Lorde-Alge plugins for guitars and bass, drums, vocals, acoustic guitars, you name it. Package deal from Waves. Pretty cool. So I'm gonna learn some things here. No bounce. What I really want to do, and I'm not sure it's possible, I just want to reconfigure this to be to have its each drum have its own track. This may be for another time. So right now, for drums, I've been doing everything within Superior Drummer, all the effects and such, but I can't do that. I can't use the new plugins if everything's headed to the same stereo out, which is really the most simple way to use this. Let's see. I mean, you could go through here. I don't think this is gonna work. Yeah, I already am missing hi-hats. And I think if I do that. That's not. Yeah, we're getting in the weeds here. Yeah, there we go. This might be for another time or another project, something I can mess with. I really want to mess with it now, though. There's probably a good chance I was listening to a lot of Tool when I wrote this. This has been a while since I wrote this. Anything is possible. There was a period of time where I was listening to 10,000 Days and stuff like that a lot. Bass just hits nice. bass is actually his running guitar rig. Interesting. His bass is running guitar rig. I want to make one other change to the bass. I want to put it through parallax. We'll just... This is going to be fun. This should punch pretty good. Hold on. Let's see what this sounds like all on its lonesome here. That is a lot of... I like Arc Reactor because it's got the high end tone. We just push the mids out. They're gone. We got low end and we got the high end there. Ace of Hearts, huh? It's got that distortion on it. Problem there is I feel like I lose the low end. But... Mod Motor, thanks for the resub. That's awesome. Ooh, we need a gate on that. No gate on here. So a ton of noise on that. Whew. Hear that again. Okay, cool. That's it. Where are we getting that noise? Hmm. shout there. Thinking, first of all, I'm gonna Ace of Hearts is interesting, but let's go with like Arc Reactor. I thought was pretty. There's a ton. Sounding legit. It is sounding legit. This thing needs some words next. Go. Try something here. I'm gonna drums too. I really want to figure out how to send, so we might as well learn something tonight, right? How to send to oh. Well, that's not cool. Mono channels. So I feel like we did this. But we, what we end up with is routing that doesn't work. So, got to read something real quick here. I think I just found an article about this today in multiple tracks. Yeah. New track, plugins, instruments, VSTI, Superior Drummer. 32 out, and you want to add the following tracks for this effect. Huh. Let's see. But should be interesting because then we got to be able to but you can't. Yeah, you get. Yeah, this is probably for another time. That's all right. I do want to learn how to do this, but for right now, we're going to leave it as is. Another time. Another time. Okay. That alone for now. Let's take a look at those other real quick at those other effects though from waves. We got we've got the tune real time too. Vocals, guitars. CLF effects. Look at that. No, I'm okay, so we're EQ, distortion, reverb, short delay, long delay, and pitch. Cool. Just your general set of effects. That's good. That's good. Cool. Don't need that on there. Boop. One thing I want to do, though, is like, let's go into a... I do want to play with the vocal stuff. I'm not in great shape to sing, but I want to see what it does, what it sounds like. So we're gonna give it our best to sing a song tonight too. Check. The stick with chai tea with sugar. It's cool. Okay. Check. Super dry. This should be super hard to listen to. I promise to try not to cough. When April rains fall and showers drown us all, oh, when colors fade to green from gray, I'll be yours.
Yikes. But I do want to play with this, so I'm going to record something. Hello. Hold on. Check. Check. Oh, the ozone's bypassed. Okay. Oh, not much. How you doing? We're just recording some goof around stuff to play with some new effects. I'm going to drop them in. I want to hear if they do a, like, if it's a real, oh, it's not bad. Not bad real time. So we got bass treble, compression, reverb, delay, and pitch. Stereo width. So, oh yeah, okay. And that's just probably super wide. Nice. So let's record a verse and a chorus here and see what it sounds like. It's totally, that's good. Make sure I don't have anything armed that I shouldn't have armed. Want to play with the vocal parts, though.
I'll be home.
place. I'll be standing anywhere. Only if you'd have me, 'cause I'll be scratch track, but good. Well, not really scratch. Let's see what it can do.
Although I think you can still hear the reverb. It's fantastic. All right. So that actually had the plugin on it. So let's. You can't hear me getting ready to sing. Excuse me. Okay, so let's chop that off. And let's just start out real quick with it's Nectar, I believe. Throw Nectar Pro on there. For nothing more than the pitch. So EQ can go, compression can go. Pitch, and the key of this is actually A major. And we're gonna do correction. I liked Jeremiah's setting. 25 milliseconds.
When April rains fall,
let's play around with this.
And showers drown us all.
It's kind of loud.
Oh, when colors fade to green from gray. When April rains fall and showers drown us all. Oh, when colors fade.
All right.
Thank you.
Cool, go ahead. What's your question? I need that vocal rider plug in. I will answer any questions. I do. I do take commissions. and we could talk offline about that. I am working on that. I'm working on revamping my commission business. I used to do it through Fiverr, but quite frankly, they take too much of the... They take it like what, 20%? So it was really, it was not turning out to be as good of a deal as I'd hoped. So I've shifted to going just through through my email. So you can hit me at that email address too. And I'll get back to you about that. I do commission work, absolutely, and I would love to. If you need some music for something, just let me know. Hit me with an email, that'd be great. Cool. contact@redwolfaudio.com. All right, let's get back to this here. I'm digging this plugin. I usually don't really like the sound of my own voice, but this is actually cleaning stuff up pretty well, so. Need a rider though. Back off that compression. Not bad. Works. Thank you. That is pretty convincing. I've never been able to do that before. Get a vocal track to sound kind of halfway the way I want it to in very little time. That's really impressive. I like that a lot. nice. Okay. I'm going to mute that out and then turn off ozone bypass. Yeah, no, I'm really happy with that. So I wish I had more vocals to work with here, but I don't have anything. Like, this is the only track with vocals that I have that is not, like, that wouldn't get me in trouble for playing on stream. So, copyright and whatnot. So, I'm going to let that sit. I'm saving that track for sure. I'm so happy with that. So, I want to mess around with, a couple other tracks and the guitar stuff tonight. But, wow. Oh, I'm just very, very happy with that. I want to go to this guy. This is another one that I wrote, instrumental track that I want to get it in good shape to play live. So we're going to take a listen to it. Instrumental perf. This has no title, working title, instrumental perf one. But here it is. And we're going to do guitar stuff to it. Okay. Thank you for the compliment on the guitar. This guitar belonged to my dad. And I inherited it from him when he passed away about 4 years ago. Yeah, so it is super sentimental, but it sounds amazing. And yeah, it's, I play it all the time. It's actually my, I don't know how he would feel about this, but it's my drop tune guitar. So this is actually tuned to drop B. Out of tune right now, but that's what happens when you bend a lot of notes. But yeah, no, it's an amazing guitar. Sounds awesome. It's great recorded, great live. So yep. And there's the culprit. Another culprit. So let's do wacky guitar stuff to this track. Cause like guitars could be bigger. I left that muted. I don't want to do that. All right. That's a lot of reverb. It's a ton of reverb on the actual. All right, so we're going to go ahead and turn that off for now. So, going back to our plugins here, doing things to it. What am I using rig for? Just the reverb. So let's just bypass that for now. And solo these guys. I thought. The left side already has more juice to it. All right. Okay. I'm going to turn off the delay. Good. We'll be right back. You guys are very kind. That lacks something. This song needs a melody, but I don't have one yet.
Thank you.
Okay, I didn't intend to play the whole song, but that works. That is an original, to answer your question, Stro. That is something we wrote a week or so, a little over a week perhaps, ago. Needs a melody. Like, I needed to find parts for some of it. That's sloppy. The point of this stream, though, was to get an idea. Of these settings. So these new plugin that I'm working with by Waves Audio and Chris Lorde-Alge. It's got a bunch of plugins for guitar, bass, acoustic guitar, drums, which I need to kind of figure that out, because the drums depend upon you actually having tracked drums in individual tracks in the DAW, which I know Superior Drummer is capable of breaking that out into individual parts, but I haven't figured that out yet. So yeah. But guitar we figured out. I think I just like the heavy setting, reamp off, and maybe a little bit of a treble boost. It just is nice. It's just a freaking great, like, I'm gonna do this one more time. I wanna maybe come up with a melody here too, but like, this is the kind of thing that gets me like inspired to write, is the new tools that make the instrument interesting to play. We'll be right back. Okay. This is good. So did we do, we did our, we played around with our guitars, right? Did we do any, we did do bass too. I want to hear that bass solo real quick. Okay. Okay, 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 cool. Yeah, there's a lot coming out there. That's good. Yeah, some song building knowledge. You know, I'm happy to share. The it's really, every song is so different. This one started with this piano part, if I remember right. Yeah, I was just goofing around on the piano. And some, it just depends, like. Oh, there's something in my left ear that I don't like. Let's sort that out. That's about it. Sometimes I come with an idea. Sometimes I come with an idea. We'll get into one in a minute that, let's see if this does us any favors. Yeah, no more crackly stuff. All right, I'm gonna set this one aside. I want to look at one more track, especially for the guitar parts, and also as I messed with this already, so this will be good. This was one where I had a defined idea though, so I'm gonna go ahead and play it and put the guitar down. Oh, do I have the bass soloed? Whoops. All right, we'll show that again. That's hilarious. Yeah, so it's been a journey for me for vocals, and I have been spend about a year now learning how to sing. So I get that completely. No, it is totally a human thing, and the fact that what you hear when you speak isn't what other people hear, it's like very disconcerting when you actually hear yourself speak. There are some wrong notes in there. but yeah, getting used to hearing yourself through headphones especially is takes a lot. What's up, Orchid? Thank you so much. Three months? Are you serious? Almost 2 years. That's so amazing. I truly appreciate it. Wow. So I think this track benefited a great deal from those new plugins. That's awesome, Stro. recording yourself and adjusting. That's what I do too. I don't know if you noticed it on the Green and Gray project. There is a rehearsal track. Actually, that's where we recorded vocals earlier. And that's exactly what I did to become comfortable singing that song, is I recorded myself and I like intentionally tried different things with my voice to try and come up with something that I was comfortable with that was like sounded like me, sounded like what I want to sound like, but is also repeatable, if that makes sense. Like something, a vocal technique that I can pull out and perform with without a whole lot of trouble. And, you know, for me, my focus is on the overall sound of things, right? So I'm here to like, I'm definitely a rock band guy when it comes to, like putting all those sounds together. I'm not a pop artist, although I mean, maybe someday that's a skill set that I'll develop. But for right now, for my singing, you know, I'm definitely comfortable in a rock setting, and so that's what I've been cultivating. But yeah, it's really about what Stro described as like getting comfortable and listening to the process and listening to your own development. I need to cough here, sorry. And excuse me, and like reapplying what you learn from that process. So, plus it's also just kind of fun to feel like you're in a rock band. So I'm trying to think of, there's one other track maybe we can play around with. What is that? Hold on. Let me consult the notebook here. The notebook. Yeah, here we go. Oh yeah. Yeah. Okay. The track known as Concept 5 at this point. I really like this tune. This one really needs words. So, but it really needs a little guitar treatment too. So I'm gonna play it as it is now. The telephone guitar. I forgot about that. What did I do? I used the riff intro. I love this guitar tone. Oh yeah, it's gonna get gnarly real fast. Okay, cool. Stroh says, yeah, it felt really whatever into like, yeah, third recording, but as soon as there was noticeable progress, stopped feeling like a crutch and became a thing I was excited to grow and felt good about. Yeah, for sure. I know exactly how you feel because that's how I feel going back and listening to really early streams where I started to sing and I was like, really unsure of myself and like I didn't even really know how to approach a microphone, how to use it as part of as part of your vocal instrument, and I'm still learning, but I feel like I do a better job now than I definitely did like 6 months ago, and I feel like I learn something new every single time I sing, so that's cool. That's great. And like, it's a lot of fun. It's just a lot of fun. And I think that's gotta be the whole point, you know, when you're doing something like this. As soon as it ceases to be fun, you know. Oh. That's cool though. No, that's really cool. Right. Stressful, yeah. I would be too. I feel like my problem would be yeah, it's way harder. My problem would be like starting it in a bad key, like forgetting that I gotta go up way up high, on the national anthem, like getting into that middle section. So I would start it too high and I'd be like, well, we're heading into falsetto land. Everybody buckle up. It's going to be real bad. I don't know. That is bravery right there. All right, let's throw this while we're chatting. I'm going to throw this in here. We're going to listen to this section here. Let's take a listen here. Right, I'd be out there with a pitch pipe, like making a fool of myself. I like the growl. Sinister. Yeah. Yes. All of that. All right. What did we just do? I like how thin and narrow that is. I love this track. I do. I can't help it. Let's listen to this. This just got, this got tough. You know what? I don't even care. Let's see what happens. I'm gonna do some things here real quick. This is what I like to do when I do make something for live performance. Hopefully that doesn't create processing issues here. Bummer. All right, let's see here. That's a bummer. Let's try this. I'm gonna go ahead and do this. Boop. I'm gonna have it unload everything and reload it. See if we can get it. to not be all weird. Because I had two loaded at the same time, and it's still doing it, isn't it? Well, that is unfortunate. Okay, we're back to normal now. That's all right. Get there eventually. This is good. I'm gonna give this another listen. Whoops. I love how much more lively the guitars are now with this new plugin. It's just amazing. Here. Now I'm just gonna do stuff for fun for a minute. That's kind of awful. There we go. Let's listen to that now. Don't need that. Sometimes you gotta make something sound awful to figure out that it actually sounded good to begin with. Alright, that's enough of that. Wow. But overall, like, the way this hits now is, especially the bass, I think. Okay. I could tweak this all night long. But so tonight, adding the CLA bass, CLA guitars, the Chris Lorde-Alge stuff from Waves to liven up the guitars, I think made a huge difference in these. We played around with a whole bunch of different stuff. Played around with, and I want to listen to this one more time. Played around with the vocal stuff too, which you know, there's really only one song that I can do vocals on at this point, because I am, you know, I'm still writing lyrics for the other tunes. But this one, Green and Gray, which is written by my friend Jeremiah Toole, this I can do because I got his permission. But I just want to listen to this one more time because this is like, I mean, shocking. Like, I was shocked. I'm shocked at how good it is. So, you know, just take a listen to this. Oops. What kind of vocals am I looking for? As far as tone, or are you talking lyrics? I don't know. I have some subjects that I want to write on. I'm gonna mess around, hold on. See what happens. It picks some interesting harmonies. Thank you. Okay. This has been an interesting production night. whoops. Pretty good. I'm definitely excited to use these plugins again. The guitars livened up, the vocals like kind of got like 3/4 of the way of where I would want them. I can actually sort of stand the sound of my own voice. so this is cool. So that's Chris Lorde-Alge plugins, his like bundle from Waves, which is very cool. There's some stuff I didn't use that I want to try doing later on. They have their own auto-tune, which is supposed to work in real time, which could be really cool for actually like singing in tune better, because what you're going to hear, what I'll hear while I'm singing is a tuned version of myself that I can then adjust to, because obviously it's always better it's better to sing in tune, right? Unless you're really going for an auto-tune sound, but you know, you don't really do that in rock. But yeah, and we'll play with it later. We'll play with it another time. I appreciate it. I appreciate the chat and the questions and the feedback. The real-time feedback is always cool. And welcome to those who've never been here before or never listened before. I appreciate you being here. So, Vivica Shots and Mod Motor, thank you for the chats. Mod Motor and Orchid, thank you for the resubs. Yeah, this was a lot of fun. So I will be back on Friday. That's the plan. Might try doing a little bit more performance. We'll see. But this is it for me for tonight. 11 o'clock is my cutoff. I appreciate everybody being here. And I hope you have a great Thursday, and hope to see you Friday. Oh, Viva Good Shots, thank you for the resub. The Prime sub 2 months is greatly, greatly, greatly appreciated. Really, really appreciate that. So everybody take care. Have a great night, and I will see you hopefully on Friday. Have a good night. Bye.